Hey, everybody, this is Mr. Chairman. Today is November 16th, and this is Wally. Hope you're all having a great day. We are going to cover how to do a review over the reproduction tracks in cattle for our summative, which will be on Thursday. So for those of you who were here for our lab a few weeks ago, this is going to be reviewed for you. If not, this might be the first time you've seen these. So I want to make sure that you are paying attention and understand what parts are what. So that you can understand it will be part of the summative that is based on a video that's a little like this. So let's talk about the areas that you need to know what they are on this reproductive tract. So the exterior part of this, we have the rectum and the vulva, excuse me. The vulva is what is our entryway to the reproductive tract. Our rectum is what we actually use to be able to feel this reproductive tract with blades right on top of it. So our vulva is what we need to know is on the exterior part of the female reproduction tract, and is what is going to protect this from everything that's outside, from that's maneuver, germs, bugs, all that stuff. So once we get past the vulva, we have this section that runs from here to here called the vagina, the vaginal tract, which is going to run in this area right here. Connecting to that, obviously, is our bladder, which is what this big pouch or bag or whatever this is, because obviously that is where our urine is going to flow into the vagina so that it exits through the vulva. When you come down the vaginal tract, right in front of this part right here, which feels more like cartilage, is harder. It's actually made up of three different rings that are going to protect the uterus from anything that's in the vagina. So this is called the cervix, and we need to. That's super duper important. Right before the cervix, though, there are small folds that almost create like a false bottom. That especially when you're AIing. So if you're going to take an AI and try to breed this cow, the first thing you need to do is be careful that you don't enter the bladder. So we talk about the bladder already. That's why we enter our AI at a 45-degree angle up, so that we avoid entering this bladder, because obviously, that's not what we want to talk to. Number two is going to be very uncomfortable for our cat. So, you want to be careful of that hornet. So, if you think about a funnel, if you're looking at the bottom of a funnel, there's one small opening, and then there's a larger kind of cone section that's past that. Well, that's very similar to the opening of the cervix. So, if you're trying to hit that with a pen or a pencil or your finger, you need to be very precise in where you're actually going. Otherwise, you're going to get out and around the entry point for the cervix. So we call that the fornix. The fornix is that false area where your AI is going to end up and you're not getting in there. So that's why it's very important that you, with your left hand, you're actually grabbing that and reducing the amount of area that fornix is in, so you make sure you're in that cervix. Then once we pass through the cervix, there's three different rings that we all need to pass through. Directly past that is called the uterine body. That's where we would actually deposit semen if we were AIing this particular cow. Because once that semen is deposited, the cow body actually tells it to start contracting, and it will pull that semen up into these uterine horns, and it will follow these down here until we get to these, which are our ovaries. So we need to know, there's a few different things that we need to know on. So first of all, we have a vulva, a vagina, a bladder, a fornix, a cervix, a uterine body, our two uterine horns, and our ovaries. And there are two different bodies on the ovaries that we need to make sure that we know. One is called a follicle, which is where it's a blister-like formation that actually releases the eggs that are produced in the ovary. And then there is a CL, a corpus luteum, that actually is where, once that egg is released and that follicle bursts open, the corpus luteum is what is created there in place of it, and it produces progesterone, and there's a number of different things that we talked about already, so I want you to go back and do that. You need to know what the corpus luteum is, you need to know what a follicle is, you need to know the ovary, the uterine horns, the uterine body, the cervix, the fornix, the vagina, the bladder, and the vulva. So with that, I hope that helps serve as a review. There will be a portion of our summative. that covers this part of the that covers this understanding, this anatomy, and what it does, and what its functions are. So I hope that